Welcome to the tutorial for a new feature of TMS FNC Maps, Element Containers. Element Containers allow you to add interactive elements to maps. But to make it much clearer, first of all, I'm going to tell you what kind of opportunities to have using Element Containers, how you specify Element Containers. Then we're going to have a look at the demo that is being bundled with a product. But before you start with that, I also give you a head start, how to build a project from the ground up using Element Containers, so you get a feel how all the different properties and events that have been added to the control can be used. Let's get started. Element Containers are containers with interactive elements. Interactive elements means added controls, buttons. You can enter things that affect the map. But also, if the user interacts with a map, these elements that you've defined can be affected by that. So it's both ways. Also, you will use HTML to specify the design of those containers. Why HTML? All the map frameworks that TMS uses in FNC Maps are HTML-based, web-based. They all use JavaScript, CSS for styling, and the language to bring this all together is HTML. Furthermore, you don't have to deal with any of that. TMS implemented full design time support for all these features. You can select properties from the object inspector, define the events from the object inspector, add code using Delphi, no web languages required. The only tricky part is that you need to define buttons or edit controls using HTML. But that is really, really basic HTML that all of us as Delphi developers can handle. So before jumping right into Delphi, here's an example what a map with Element Containers looks like. On the right top corner, you see an Element Container as a menu bar that even allows you to have menu items. The first two items are directly clickable, and the other one here, the options one, opens up a menu. Formally, this is a nav bar in Bootstrap. If you look to the lower left, you can affect the zoom level of the map using a sliding control or slider control, which is also part of Bootstrap. And finally, on the right bottom corner, you can see the map location, the latitude and the longitude. And both of these coordinates are updated while you move. On the other hand, you can click update after entering values to move the map. This is the application that you just saw. I haven't said anything so far about the mapping services that are supported. All the mapping services that TMS FNC Maps supports offer now the support for Element Containers. Right now, we're going to use OpenLayers because OpenLayers doesn't put any restrictions on us. We can use it without specifying an API key, without signing any paperwork. OpenLayers is available for everyone. So this demonstration can be used if you download the trial version of FNC Maps out of the box. You don't need to acquire any keys. You can tinker around with it as you wish. So moving the map around, you see that the coordinates on the right get updated. If you zoom out and in, you can see that the zoom level also is updated. On the other hand, you can also slide the control here and the map reacts to it. So it really is a two-way binding, as you might refer to it formally. Zooming out and moving over to Europe, for example, right here, you see that the latitude and longitude is updated as well. On the other hand, you can go to the latitude 44, click update, and the map jumps. So all of this works two-way without very, very little code. The same goes for the navigation bar on the right upper corner. You can, for example, now, if you zoom into Germany, Würzburg, and then add a marker at center, you see that you can also define custom code that is to be executed. It is not restricted to anything that interacts with the movement or with the zoom or the map. You can define any action that you want on any of these elements. And finally, you can also define submenus using HTML accordingly. The trick here is that this It's a navigation bar in Bootstrap, and navigation bars offer you the ability to have submenus. However, this is already a very complex example, and let me get you started with a very simple example right from scratch, step by step. The application is only going to use one form. And on this form, I dropped a map control of type TTMS FNC maps. I did assign, however, an API key for the Google map control. So this is actually a Google map. It is not an open layer. You can see that by looking at the services property or service property, MS Google Maps. That means now we're using the Google service to display this map. At design time, you can even interact with this map already. Just in case, I define anchors. So if the user resizes the form, the map control resizes with it. The focus of this talk is going to be how to add element containers to the top of the map. What I would like to offer my users is they should be able to switch between the mapping providers inside of the map. So I'll add two buttons here, one for open layer to switch to the open layer view, and another button to switch back to Google. This will be very easy to do. And for each of the element containers that you will add to your maps, these steps will be precisely the same. The only difference is the HTML that you will have to type in order to do the design of your element containers. So let's get started by looking at the control on which properties have been added to it. First of all, rename the maps control. Let's rename it to maps so we can address it in code easily. Also, let's change the caption of the form. This is going to be our element container demo. Okay. Just looks nicer. And now looking at the control, at the map control, always click on the top line right here, not inside, because then you interact with the map. Click here in order to select the control or select the control in the object inspector directly. And what has been added is the element containers property, which is a list editor right here. Let me expand it for you. And adding an element container immediately shows a white canvas on the top left. Top left, because the position is set to top left. Let's move it over to the right. So we say top right. There it is. Now we have the canvas that we can add our HTML elements to. And the HTML elements that we're going to add are going to be buckets. So clicking on the element container, we want to add HTML. So the property we have to use is HTML. We click it, and there we get a string list editor to add our HTML. I suggest you prepare this in a separate editor and just paste it, because then you have like code highlighting. This string list editor obviously doesn't have code highlighting for HTML. So I just paste the HTML that I prepared previously, and I have two HTML tags of type button with the ID. And this is very important. You have to be able to refer to your controls later on. So I name this button one. I rename it to button open layers, and button two I rename to button Google. So those will be the buttons that are used to switch between the different services. And I'm able to use style sheets from Bootstrap right here. Button, button, primary, button, primary both times. And if I click OK, the design time immediately updates, but the buttons obviously don't look right. This is not the style that I was thinking of. And the reason is pretty simple. You refer to something that is defined in CSS, but how should the map control know where the CSS is, right? So we need to tell the control where to look for the CSS, where to look for JavaScript that is associated with the design that we're placing in our map. So in order to do that, we have the so-called head links section. We don't find that here because it is defined for the whole map, not just for the container. So we switch over to the map, and there you find the property head links. And there you can define, after adding one, Let's see, lever sizing is not easy here. So click, and we add a TMS FNC maps head link item. And there we can see we can add either a script, a style, or a link to a style. And the link also has to specify the rel property, which is something like style sheet, for example. And that's exactly what we're going to do. We are going to grab the link. That's what I'm doing on my the display here. I'm copying the link from the Bootstrap webpage right here. That's the link for the Bootstrap style sheet. You can see here, bootstrap-min.css. And this is not a script. No, this is a link, because this is the link that's supposed to be used. And inside of that link is a style sheet. So I'm going to type style sheet, boom. And voila, immediately the design time updates and you see the resulting buttons as they should look. They're styled with the Bootstrap theme. Amazing, if you ask me. This is just great. So we will add two more things in order for this to work. We will add two more head links. Another one we need is jQuery. It's another JavaScript library. So we say URL, paste, and it's a JS file, it's a script, so we don't need to change the default properties. And the other thing is Bootstrap also has JavaScript elements. For example, if you were to add the navigation bar and it expands and collapses the menu, for that you need JavaScript. So you can add that as well using the URL. Poof. That's bootstrap-min.js. And to make it all a little bit clearer, if we switch over to code. So this is the Bootstrap JavaScript. Then we have the jQuery JavaScript. And finally, the element that we added first, the Bootstrap library itself, the CSS with the stylesheet relation added as well. So these are the three parts that I added as head links right here. So going back to the design. Now we even get the, I hope you can see that in the video, we even get the interactions with the buttons, that if I hover over a button, all of this is working now because we imported all the JavaScript and all the CSS. The reason why I put these three parts here is that these three give you a good base for anything that you might want to do with FNC maps and interactive elements. This is a good base, and you might not even need much more short term. The last part that is still missing, we need to add code to our buttons. And again, FNC Maps makes it very, very easy. So we select the map again, and then we go to the element containers and open up the list of element containers. We only have one. The whole thing is the container, and the container has different HTML elements in there. Just as a reminder, let me open it back up. So you see that we have a button with this ID and another button with that ID. The ID button open layers, and this has the ID button Google. So we have two HTML elements. And TMS wrote the framework in a way that these things are being scanned and makes it accessible at design time in Delphi. So clicking on the actions property right here, it gives us another editor. And this editor can, if you add two actions, we have two actions. We want to implement clicking on this button and clicking on the other button. So let's go to the first one with the index 0. And look at this right here. You have to specify an HTML element ID. This links one action to this item. So if you click on the drop box, you see that you can either pick button Google. That's why I named them like this. Not only button one, button two. No, very explicit. So button Google, what should happen and with what action should it happen? So here, when you click, you can do you can do double click, focus, mouse down, mouse enter. No, we just want to have the click here. It is enabled, and the action is going to be action zero, action switch to Google. That's what I name the action. And what is happening? Okay, we switch over to events. And then just like an action list, and I think they have been introduced in DAO 5.4, we click on execute and tab. And now we can say what is supposed to happen if the user switches, clicks there. So we say map dot or maps dot. And then the service property has to change if we click on Google to Google, of course. So we say msg command completion and Google Maps enter. That's it. So if we click on that button, we would like for the button to set the service to Google. Perfect. And the same thing we can do now for the second element. This is the action open layers, well, which is the element ID. Button open layers, and the event is going to be on execute maps.service equals ms open command completion or code completion, boom, ms open layers. Save, run. Let's see what happens. I'm pretty optimistic. So we have the resizing right here. Perfect. And let's switch to open layers. Poof. That's the map in open layers. Let's switch back to Google. Boom, back to Google. And best of all, you might have guessed it, but let's set a breakpoint here. Let's run this with debugging. And of course, I set the to the open layers one. I click here and the debugger stops. So full debugging support for the whole thing. It is amazing. You link HTML, put it on a map, which is rendered using a JavaScript HTML API. And what can you focus on? You can focus on the Delphi programming, and you need a little bit of HTML design, which is so basic that even I, as a Delphi developer and not being a web designer, can do these things. So great job, TMS, and I hope you're just as excited about this new feature as I am. See you soon.